Hey, I'm Jake, and I've been making a game called A Short Odyssey. It's been a while since I've made a video, so I figured I'd just give a quick update on some things I've been working on, so I hope you enjoy. Challenges I've dealt with was adding pathfinding to the game. So if you've never heard of that or you don't know what pathfinding is, basically it's the process that an enemy or a non-player character uses to get from one point in the world to another. So they got to figure out like what's the path they're going to follow, how are they going to go around certain objects. So basically if you don't have good pathfinding, what happens is that you end up with enemies like walking into walls, falling into pits, or just generally acting pretty stupid. It's kind of funny to watch, actually. So how was I going to go ahead and add pathfinding to my engine? So basically, if you Google how to do pathfinding, what you're probably going to find is an algorithm called A*. Now, A* is a perfectly good pathfinding algorithm, and there are even plenty of videos on YouTube explaining how to do it. And if you ask in any sort of online game development community, you're almost certainly going to be told, just use A*. So let's go ahead and do that. So like a real game dev, I thought I could just copy-paste some code and it'll just work. So unfortunately, all the code I found to copy-paste was for Unity, and since I'm using a custom engine, I didn't have the greatest time, so we're back to square one. What's all these red squiggles? What are all these red f***ing squiggles? I copy-pasted this code. It's supposed to work. I don't know. Maybe you can't just copy-paste code for Unity and expect that it works in an engine that isn't Unity. Sources explaining A* almost always represent the world as a grid of tiles, and they mark which tiles you can walk on and which tiles you can't. Now, this works great if you're just trying to explain the algorithm, or if your game has a natural grid structure to it, like Minecraft or an older real-time strategy game. But the problem is, when you have a game like mine, where the environments are a little bit more freeform and naturalistic, you have to have quite a fine grid to capture all that data. So you're going to waste a lot of memory doing that, basically. So what you actually need to do, and what I did, was to use a format called a NavMesh. A NavMesh stores the same idea, like that there are tiles you can walk on and tiles you can't. But these are sort of arbitrarily sized polygons, so you can sort of fit the navigation data to the actual world, and it's a lot more flexible. Okay, so now that I've decided I need a NavMesh, how do I actually make a NavMesh? Like, how do I do that? And also, how am I gonna store a NavMesh? Like, if I have a huge world, I'm gonna need a huge NavMesh, and that's still gonna take a lot of data to store, even if it's smaller than a grid. And also, like, what happens if something in the world moves and creates a new obstacle? Like, do you have to make a new NavMesh? So I decided to use a tried and true method from software engineering, and that is, I used somebody else's code. Now, in this case, it's the recast and detour libraries. Now, these are actually used by some pretty big engines like Unreal, and they actually work pretty well. So now that's great. So I can just throw my world geometry at recast and it can generate a NavMesh, right? Great, okay, but there's one problem. Generating a NavMesh is actually really slow. So why is it a problem that generating the NavMesh is slow? Can't we just generate it once when we load the game and then not have to worry about it? Well, unfortunately not, and that's because, as I alluded to earlier, when something in the world changes, like a tree falls over and it blocks a path, or an explosion knocks a wall down, that changes how the paths need to work and how the places that people can navigate. So we need to update the NavMesh. Now, if we rebuild the entire NavMesh, that's gonna lag the game out really hard, and that's just a no-go. So we're actually gonna tackle this problem a couple different ways. So the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna subdivide our big NavMesh into a bunch of smaller NavMeshes. Now, what we're basically doing is we're building a grid of tiles where each tile is its own NavMesh. Now, the second thing we're going to do with those tiles is that we're only going to generate them when there is an NPC nearby. And that's because, since the NPCs are the things that walk on the tiles, if there's no NPC, then we don't even need a tile. Now that saves us a ton of processing. And the third thing we're going to do is we're going to kick off the generation of tiles to a background thread. Now, this is going to allow our game logic to keep processing. So even if the tile generation takes longer than we expected, then it's not going to lag out the game. The game's going to keep going. So also, instead of updating the tile every time something moves, which could theoretically happen every frame, we're actually only going to update the tile if it hasn't been updated in the last 100 milliseconds. So basically, that's fine. Like, 100 millisecond old data is fine, because, like, if you think about it, human reaction time is often not that fast anyway. So you're not actually going to notice that the AI hasn't reacted to a change in the path in like a tenth of a second, right? So there we go. Now we have a pathfinding system that works across the entire world, can react to any kind of dynamic changes in the world, and as a bonus, it's quite efficient. So great. Why don't we move on to talk about something else? So why don't we talk about the climbing system I've been working on? Now, there are plenty of examples of climbing in video games, and they actually vary quite a bit. Now, they kind of range from basically being able to free climb anything to having like very specific points that the developer has placed for the player to climb. Now, I didn't really like the idea of my player being able to climb sheer cliff, but I also didn't like the idea of myself having to place little points, because I don't have that kind of time. And also, I wanted the game to be able to deal with situations that I didn't personally anticipate. So what if instead of placing all these points manually, I had the game figure it out automatically? Now, that's actually exactly what I did. Now, using raycasts, which are a common feature of physics engines, my character can examine what the world around them looks like and actually detect where certain climbable ledges are based on the shape of them. This is great because not only did it save me a ton of work, but also it can react to changes to the world in real time, like, for example, a wall collapsing and being able to climb on the rubble. So the final step was animation. So I took my character and I popped over to Mixamo and I found some animations that looked like they fit the bill. I then spent way too long tweaking them. But now that everything's together, we can kind of see using my animation blending system that now we actually have a very nice looking fluid animation going on, and our climbing action actually looks pretty good. He can move from side to side, he can climb up onto the ledge, and he can drop down from the ledge. Just everything you'd kind of expect. So great. So there we go. I hope you enjoyed hearing about what I've been working on in the last little while. And if you like these videos and you want to see more like this, you can subscribe down below, and I will try not to spend so long before the next video, but who knows. Also, if you want to see sort of like shorter form content, I sometimes post on my shorts and also on my Instagram, which you can find linked down below. And if there's anything you guys want to hear about, please feel free to sound off in the comments. Bye!